Okay guys, welcome back for yet another tutorial on Adobe Premiere Pro CS3. Today we're going to be looking at how to make titles. And so, since it's a fairly large title editing and creation tool in Adobe Premiere, there's a bunch of features. I'm going to be splitting this into two 10-minute videos, or roughly 10 minutes. So, let's get started and look at a few ways how we can create a title. We can go up to Title, New Title, and Create from here. We can go up to File, New. We can right over there and click Title. We can hit Control T, or we can even go down here to the New Item bin, New Item in the Project panel, and click Title from there. I find myself using the Control T command because it's really quick and easy. My hand's already on the keyboard because I use the JK and L key as well as the I and O, so it's just a nice command there. So first thing it asks you to do is to name your title. So we're going to name this one Title 1. And Premiere will, in this case, it's going to slowly open because my computer's been on for quite some time now. And could probably use a reset, but it wasn't too bad. If you have something like an Internet Explorer or Firefox, any web browser open, it's going to slow down your machine a little bit more. But the first thing we get here is this huge window that we look at in the middle. And you'll notice it has what we have on our main timeline, a digital set. You could turn that off, or you can simply move your current time indicator past the point where you have your digital set. It's basically moving your current time indicator on the main timeline. As always, you could single click them and type in a time code. And the first thing I do want to say though is that I'm not going to be going over every little thing in here. There are just so many different choices, so many different selections and buttons and features that we don't have time to go through this. We'll be here for 5 or 6 videos if I go through everything. So I'm going to go through the basics, and I'm going to start off with the selection tool up here. This is going to allow you to select and resize and adjust to even rotate your text boxes after you create them. Over here we have a rotation tool specifically for rotating text. It makes it a little bit easier. We have the type tool and the vertical type tool, so you can do vertical type down text or standard text. You can click or you can drag out a text box. If you click, you're going to be typing it, and it's going to be expanding your text box, and before you know it, it's going to go off screen. If you draw a text box, it's going to do an auto word wrap for you. We jump back to the selection tool here. You'll notice if we go near an edge, we can actually rotate this. And if we hold shift, we can actually get different angles and get it nice and straight. If we go on one of these corner boxes, we can easily resize our text box. Moving down here, we have the pen tool, so we can first off, click once, click a second spot, and if you click and hold, you'll be able to make curves and such using these little handles that Premiere puts out here. And when you're done with the line, you can also double click and it'll end where your last point was. At any point, you can use the pen tool to simply move your points around or readjust your curve. We'll jump back a few steps and we have our text up here. Moving down here, we have basic drawing tools, like we can do rectangles. Different shapes really easily, and we do have a line tool. All these can be rotated as usual, just so you do use your selection tool, you can rotate everything here. Moving down here, I want to focus your attention on the centering options. If we choose to select our text box here, we can center up our text vertically and horizontally with one click, which is a very nice feature, and you'll use that quite a bit. Looking down here, we have a bunch of different title styles that we can choose from, and it'll automatically update everything. Everything from different color types. The different font types, and there's quite a few nice ones in here, and there are quite a few to choose from as well. Some of these have drop shadows, so if you were to, probably best to turn off the background image, you can see the drop shadow right here. Moving over towards the right, I'm not going to be going over all these options, but these are basically your transform and your properties for your titles, so you're going to be able to change quite a bit when it comes through to making your title. That we're going to go over through in the next video. For now, we're going to look at some of these options up here. As always, we have our basic bold, italic, underline. We have different font styles here. Font size we could change. We can change the spacing. And if you had text over or below, you could change the vertical spacing as well. Do take note that you can go negative on here too. And you can click in parameters. We can center justify, left center, left center or right justify. And when it comes to making... draw a marquee around both of these boxes and delete them. When it comes to making rolling credits and such for the end of your video, which we'll also go through in the next video. It's a good idea to use the tab stop button here at the top. And the first thing you want to do is expand this out, so it'll make it easier to work with. But you're going to be able to choose the left one here, and right in this little strip, you're going to click and drag your markers out. I like to put one in the center, one on the left, and one on the right. And at this point, you can simply type in things like producer, put your name down, and you'll see that if you hit tab, the tab key will actually position you at each point. So it's a nice feature that Premiere puts in that you can do, and it easily allows you to create your tab stops. That would be nice rolling up the screen. Of course, we would choose something a little bit less bold. As I said, you can turn on and off your background if you choose to do so, and scroll through the main timeline. And there is a few buttons up here, and I'm going to save these for the next video because they get pretty advanced. So with that said, guys, this is going to wrap up this first video. So now you should know how to make basic titles and such. It's a really nice title creation tool, easy to work with, and there's a bunch of different options compared to other title and nonlinear editing tools out there. So play around with it and stay tuned for the next video. Thanks for watching.